Shane's girlfriend trying to stay undefeated in the Santa Ynez with trainer Doug O'Neill. Take me back to the Delta Princess. We got to stand with Leandro as he was watching it. He was almost rendered speechless. What were your thoughts of her performance that day?
It was insane, you know, to her debut was so impressive, and then to put her on a plane and take her there second time out, going two turns. You know, we were asking a lot of her, and to see what she did there, really, it was very special.
Has she always been a horse that's trained well in the morning, shown you a lot of talent?
She has, but a lot of them do, but you really never know till you lead them over there, and she's one of the ones that fortunately brought her morning activity into the afternoon, and she's very average to look at, really, but she jumps a long way, and it's got a lot of heart.
She was a force to be reckoned with in that race, but you're facing a very impressive maiden winner in Unique Bella. How do you think that they stack up?
I don't know. Yeah, you know, we had one in that race against Unique Bella, and we were saddling a couple stalls down from Jerry and his crew, and man, she's a beast. She is absolutely, she's a big, beautiful filly, and she ran huge her last race, so... it's going to be a great race, and I know Baffert's got a couple in there too, I think. So it's going to be a real interesting race, but I wouldn't trade place with anybody.
Quality field for sure. You were considering running against the boys in the Sham Stakes yesterday. Why did you opt to face the fillies and cut back in distance?
You know, it was just kind of a team decision. WC boys and the other partners, and just decided to keep her against the fillies. You know, it makes the most sense. And I'm just not crazy. Once they go two turns, bringing horses back to one turn, but hopefully later today we'll be happy with our decision.
And that being said, where do you think we'll see her within the field on the cutback?
You know, I love her post. I love the continuity, having the same pilot on her. So I see her laying right in the garden spot, third or fourth, something like that. But she's got the speed to be up there, too, if something happens and a few of them don't break as well. But it's in Flavian hands, and she ate up last night. And there she is right there looking out of stall one. And she's got her game face on, ready to roll.
You have two other entrants within the field. What are your thoughts on the other two fillies?
They're nice fillies. They're probably not ready at this point, so the tentative plan is to scratch both of them and go into allowance spots. So I'm in the middle of calling the owners and talking that through, but we had talked yesterday with both clients of those horses, and both fillies are doing well, but they're in kind of deep water today, so we're going to look for softer spots.
Okay, thank you for the update, and best of luck today.
I'm actually going to go back in the office. TVG2, I don't know if you guys know this.
Yeah, I know it.
Oh, unbelievable show, The Starting Gate with Mike Joyce. It's incredible. So if we're down at the track, we just TiVo it and we come back and watch it. But it's a must watch.
Did you know you're on The Starting Gate right now?
I'm on The Starting Gate. What?
You're special. Wow. You are really special.
Why didn't you tell me before? I'd have been real nervous. This is like the Letterman show. So this is crazy. Cool stuff. Mike, how you doing, brother? Good to see you.
We got our very own David Letterman in the studio. That's Mike Joyce.
There he is. I love it. Well, thanks for having me on this show. This is unbelievable.
Doug, thank you for your time and good luck today.
Thank you.
And from what I'm hearing, you guys, Shane and his girlfriend will be at the track today. So that should be interesting. Best of luck to them, Shane's girlfriend, in the Santa Ynez.